there, I'm Parveen, and welcome back to my channel, Exploring Me, where I explore different aspects of my life, both professionally and personally. Today, this is not necessarily about work. I am exploring Victoria, British Columbia, which is out on Vancouver Island off the coast of the mainland of British Columbia, for those of you that are less familiar. I'm only here for the night. My main reason of coming is actually I booked this Airbnb. It's called the Common Place, and it's modeled after sort of the Gryffindor Common Room. I wanted to stay here forever, but it's usually always booked up whenever I check. For whatever reason, it popped up on my suggested and it actually had like one day free. So I actually took off the Monday and I'm here on a Sunday. I came in this morning fairly early. I took in the 7 a.m. ferry and then I drove into town. My plan is to go out and do the hike at Old Baldy Mountain. I think that's what it's called. But I actually headed into town to have breakfast and I went to a place called Bear and Joey. I didn't realize you needed reservations, but luckily since I'm just by myself, I was able to get a seat out on the patio and it was really great. So now I am driving out about an hour to start the hike. All right, so I'm still making my way down the trail at Old Baldy Mountain, and I thought I would check in about how I found it. I took the trail from the yellow gate. I know there's also a red gate somewhere. I don't know exactly where that is. I would definitely suggest the yellow trail. I think a lot of the reviews online are a little bit misleading. It took me under 30 minutes to get to the top, and I'm almost down at the bottom, I would say in like 15-20 minutes, so it's fairly easy if you're like a semi-regular hiker. I wouldn't call myself someone who's like super fit, but I found it relatively easy. I think that the first maybe 5 to 10 minutes are fairly steep. Not so steep that you have like stop and take breaks, but like steep enough that I had to like stop and take a couple breaths. And then after that, it's fairly even and fairly easy from there. It took me a while to find the swing, but I finally did. I realized that it wasn't actually further past the summit. It was actually down at the first viewpoint. So that's a little bit of a tip, but I'll check in with you when I get back down. So I've made it back down to my car now. I very much overestimated how long that hike would take me. So I have a bit of time to kill before I am actually able to check into my Airbnb, which is sort of the main reason that I'm here this weekend. I do have a list of different coffee shops I wanted to visit in Victoria. So I'm gonna go try to navigate to one of those. Making my way to the Airbnb. When you first walk in, this is your view. Of course, there's the fat lady to get into the Gryffindor Common Room, but in the entrance, there's student robes, and if you go up the walls, there's different portraits. All of the walls are full on castle decor. And as you start to walk in, even the doors, I think that's to the bathroom, are decorated. We have some tapestries, there's the kitchen, and then you walk into the Gryffindor Common Room. I'm going to have to do close-ups of all of the details included in this. There's a loft bed up there. Continue. Of course, a fireplace. The details are actually insane. And of course, there is even wizard's chest. Okay, this is another view from where you have your little wizard's chest patio set. I'm gonna try to go up those stairs and check out from above. Okay, it's actually really small up here. I can't actually fully stand up, but I mean, there's the bed. It gets the job done. I'm not gonna be staying here for long, so I mean, it's fine. I feel like the main attraction is definitely down there in the Gryffindor Common Room. I'm gonna show you around to some of the details now. Okay, I was wrong earlier about the room in the hallway being the bathroom. It's actually this room here. There's some fun decor in there as well. We have a stained glass mermaid door. The bathroom is actually quite small, But of course we have moaning myrtle and a tapestry in here as well. I just read some of the welcome information here, and they actually give you a couple different souvenirs, including Harry's wand, the Hogwarts letter, a ticket to the Hogwarts Express, a Gryffindor scarf, and another type of ticket to platform 9 3/4, and get to keep these and take them home with you. One other fun thing I found while looking at the welcome sheet is that there's actually a scavenger hunt for all of Voldemort's Horcruxes around the apartment. So I won't spoil where they are, but I'll probably be doing that later today. I don't expect to do much else today other than explore this Airbnb. I think I'm going to order delivery to this place in a little bit and just relax. Probably going to watch at least one Harry Potter movie, if not two, but I'll check in tomorrow where I'll actually be doing other things than watching Netflix. Had to go grab some of my stuff, but this is the hallway that you enter the Airbnb from. Good morning. I am on day two of being here in Victoria. Yesterday, I basically just finished the first Harry Potter movie and then admittedly watched some Netflix. I've been rewatching New Girl for what's probably like the third time. So I did that. I did end up going for a walk around sunset just up to Parliament Building and back, which is fairly close to here. Today is pretty relaxed in that my ferry leaves at 6, so probably going to need to be there a little early, and it takes like 40 minutes to drive from here, so that'll basically be the late afternoon for me. Today I plan to check out Craigdorich Castle. I probably butchered that, but I think it's actually closed today as a museum, so I won't be able to check out the inside, but hopefully I can have a picnic on the lawn or something like that for lunch, and then I hope to check out the Fisherman's Wharf before heading out. But I'll keep you posted. Right now, this morning, I went to grab a coffee from a place called Hey Happy. It's really close to here. I don't know, it's a QVC commercial, but check that out, it's really good. I recommend it. So I did that this morning, and then I'm gonna be checking out soon. So I will see you when I have packed up and I'm ready to leave. All right, so I'm all packed up and ready to go. I'm just parked across the street. Here's another quick view of this Airbnb. I definitely think it's worth it. It is a little pricey, but I think for like a fun novelty trip, for me at least, it was worth it. One like tip there I have for you is if you can get in on a weekday, it was significantly cheaper from what I remember. Like I stayed on a Sunday and then I'm like checking out on a Monday. That was much cheaper than doing like a Friday, Saturday type of thing. So if you're a Harry Potter fan like me, this is definitely something to check out. There was a lot of construction around Craigdorich Castle, and I think because it's closed, you couldn't actually get into it. So I saw it from afar. I'm not too disappointed. It wasn't something that was like super high priority. But as I was lost navigating the construction detours around this place, I found this like open garden. I don't actually know what it's called, but I'm gonna go try to check it out. All right, I'm still walking around this garden now. I actually still have no idea what it is. I'll try to put it in the description of this video at least, but it was really beautiful. There's like different flowers and like many paths to walk around. It's quite beautiful. So this has been a nice happy surprise that I had no intention of doing today. I don't know if anyone else is like this, but I am like, if I have a schedule, I have to stick to it. And I'm not afraid of like the authority behind the schedule. Even if the schedule is made by me, I have to stick to it. What is gonna happen if I don't? I don't know. It's just something, I don't know, anxiety inducing for me. Maybe this thing has a name, but
I don't know. I like to stick to a schedule, so I'm happy that I did something spontaneous today.
Okay, I'm back in my car now. I'm gonna head out to lunch. I wanna try out the Very Good Butcher. I think it's a vegan, if not vegetarian, restaurant here in Victoria. I've heard a lot about it, or at least seen it a lot online, so I'm gonna drive over there now. I made it down to Fisherman's Wharf. It was quite crowded, more than I was expecting it to be. I think unless there's a specific restaurant you're after, you might want to skip out on this one. It is really pretty, so I'm just going to do a quick walk around and then head out. I overestimated how long it would take me to get back to the ferry terminal, so I'm actually going to be taking the earlier ferry back home. After Fisherman's Wharf, I actually just walked around downtown, checked out Chinatown, went to a coffee shop before I headed out to Swartz Bay to get the ferry back home. But that's going to be it from this vlog. I hope you'll consider sticking around and subscribing, and I'll catch you in the next one.